It's so great to have you here on this Resurrection Sunday. Christ is risen. Why don't you join with us as we sing, Who Breaks the Power?
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings.
Who shakes the whole earth?
Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings.
This is amazing grace.
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done.
Chaos
back into order. Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings.
You rule the nations.
Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. Thank you.
church, we're going to continue singing as we sing this next song, God So Loved. Come on, clap your hands with me. Come on, let's sing.
Come all you weary, come all you thirsty, come to the well that never runs dry. Drink all the water, come and thirst no more.
Come all you sinners,
come all you sinners, come find his mercy. Come to the table, he will satisfy. Taste of his goodness, find what you're looking for.
This morning on Resurrection Sunday. Why don't you continue to sing with us this morning? Let's sing, You Call the Sun to Rise.
You call the sun to rise, and you lay it down to rest.
You hold this heart.
You hold this heart of mine, and you hold my every breath. Such an awesome God, so mighty, so holy, so wonderful. Such an selfless, so
majesty.
Seated in majesty.
Is risen from the dead, and he is alive, and he can do the very same things today as he did when he walked this earth. And it's my prayer that we will witness that today as people share their faith through going through the waters of baptism, as we open up his word, and as we share together. Join with me as we pray. Loving Father, we thank you for Jesus, the greatest gift that you could give us. We thank you that though he was fully God, your son, he became a man and walked among us, showed us what you're really like, and died on a cross to take away the barrier that separated you from us. We thank you that our sins can be forgiven, that the barrier of sin can be removed. And we thank you that Jesus died on Good Friday, but Lord, we are so thrilled that he rose on Easter Sunday and that he is alive in our world today. And so, Lord, we pray that through the gift of the Holy Spirit, whom Jesus sent when he went back into your presence, you would preside among us, touch our hearts, encourage us to see and understand who Jesus is. And as we celebrate the testimonials of people who have placed their faith in Jesus, continue in our presence, touch every heart. We pray it in Christ's name. Amen. You may be seated. Now, we are delighted this morning, for the Good Friday service, that we have all of our primary school age kids with us. And so the kids have an activity pack. If for some reason, parents, you didn't grab one, you can grab one in the foyer, or the ushers will bring one to you. And so the children are welcome to stay with us. If you felt, because they might need a little bit of space, we are actually televising the whole thing in the community hall. There's space there, and so you just be wise in that. But the children are welcome among us, but feel free to use the hall or even the special room for little kids, little babies, near the entranceway. And while they're getting ready, let's just look at the screen on just what's happening in the life of our church over the next few weeks.
Hello and welcome to the Christian Family Centre. We are so glad that you can make it to our Easter service this Sunday. I'm Nick.
And I'm Rachel, and we're so excited to share with you some of the things that go on in the life of our church.
So let's jump into church news right now.
The Christian Family Centre is a church for all people and all ages. And we would love you to come visit one of our services which we host over the weekend. Come join us at Friday 11 a.m. or on Sundays at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m. or our 5:30 p.m. service.
We have several different programs running across the church for kids and young people. On Sunday mornings, we have our CFC Kids program running alongside the 10:30 service. On Friday afternoons, we have Breakout, which is for primary school age kids and starts at 4 p.m. On Friday nights, we have CFC Youth, which is for teenagers from years 6 to 12. If you fit any of those age categories, we would love you to come along.
Also during the week, we have our midweek life groups that get together just to do life with one another. These are a great way to support and love one another. And if you want to join one, please let us know on a Connect card or talk to a pastoral leader today.
Well, that is just some of the things that happen within the life of our church, but we want to thank you for coming and joining us this Easter Sunday.
If you want to find out more about what goes on at CFC, feel free to check out one of our social media accounts at CFC Seton on Instagram and Facebook. Or if you want to check out some of our previous messages, head over to YouTube at Family Centre TV.
Thank you again for joining us, and we hope you have a fantastic rest of the day, and we want to wish you all a happy Easter.
Only a real living Jesus can change lives so radically. Hundreds of millions of people testify, not just this Easter Sunday, but every Sunday, every day, that he is risen and that he has revealed himself to them through the Holy Spirit. Jesus appeared to his 12 disciples and to hundreds of people. On one occasion, it says there were something like 500 people at one time in the 50 days between Jesus rising from his crucifixion, rising from the dead, to when he ascended. People saw him, talked with him. They were able to put their hands in the side of where he was wounded and see the wounds in his hands. When you look at all the evidence of the scriptures and you look at the evidence of those who were anti-Christian, who wrote that he existed, there's no doubt that Jesus of Nazareth existed. There is no doubt that he was murdered, killed under Pontius Pilate. You can read about it in Tacitus, the Roman historian, Pliny, the Syrian historian, Josephus. There's no doubt. The gospel writers, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, tell us why he died and testify to the resurrection. And hundreds of people testify to the resurrection. And I remember when I was a young guy and I had some doubts. I just thinking, well, I want to just find out what the evidence is. And so I grabbed a book. I didn't realize how powerful the book was, written by a top British lawyer in the early 1900s named Frank Morrison. And he was an atheist. And he said, I'm going to prove once and for all. I'm going to get all the evidence. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Book of Acts, Tacitus, Suetonius, Pliny, Josephus, all of them, line it all up. And I'm going to do a legal case like a court of law and prove that it's a bunch of lies. So Frank Morrison did the research and he got converted through the process. The book is called Who Moved the Stone? The book that refused to be written almost. And he was converted to Christ. And Morrison, as a top lawyer, QC, a lot of people have taken his material. And I went through it all and I thought, there's no other explanation. There is absolutely no other explanation that he actually rose from the dead. But you know what? To this morning, we have had practical proof that he's risen from the dead by these eight guys who have actually said, Jesus is real to me. Jesus has changed me. Jesus has forgiven me. They're either lunatics, they're either liars, lunatics, or insane, but I look at them and I think they are most sane, they are most sensible, they were reasonable. In fact, they dug out scriptures that I haven't even included in my message. Hundreds of millions of people the world over say Jesus appears to us, not physically in a person. He's now in heaven with his Father, but through his Holy Spirit. As we read his word and read the story, the Holy Spirit starts to speak to us. And today, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of millions of people testify that he is alive. He appeared to me as a 17-year-old. My wife of 43 years, probably he appeared to her when she was 8 years of age, coming from a terribly violent, abusive family. And after a shocking beating, this little kid goes to her room and Jesus turns up. She doesn't know whether it was real or a vision or what, but she starts weeping. She starts calling out to God. And she basically became a Christian as an eight-year-old. She said to me, she goes, that kept me all my teenage years, that I knew God loved me and I knew Jesus was real. We have a man in our church, a Persian man from Iran, named Vahid, and he shared on Friday morning. And you read his story, and 3 years ago, Jesus appeared to him in a vision, powerfully, and converted him. And so now he is actually sending materials to his family and members of his family in Iran, Persia. And you read his story, it's amazing. And I had dear Tom who said to me, Bill, it's 21 years ago, I was a publican. My pub was next to a sex shop or something like that. He goes, I was living a terrible lifestyle. He goes, I can't believe that I'm here loving Jesus in your church. And he got saved here 21 years ago, and it's proven the test of time. He goes, you don't know how rough I was. And I nearly said to him, looking at you, Tom, I think I can. And so Jesus can save a child that's 8 years of age, appear to them. He can reach a tough publican who's lived a wild life. He can touch a Muslim Persian man who's scared for his family. They find out that they could kill his family in that nation run by these fanatics. He is real. Look what Peter says. I want to read this scripture. You guys didn't say this one. I'm going to give you this one. All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So Peter, the apostle, goes, praise God. It is by his great mercy, not because of what you have done or what we have done, but because of his love that he sent his son to die on a cross to pay the price that we couldn't pay. That we have been born again or born from above, spiritual rebirth, because God raised Jesus from the dead. Wow. We can't experience Christ unless he's alive. The Apostle Paul said, if he didn't rise, he goes, our faith is futile. We're worshipping a dead man. You might as well join any other religion, any other philosophy. Because we have a risen Saviour. He's alive today. And Paul says these words in 2 Corinthians 5:17, I think someone quoted this one. This means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, the new life has begun. I love this translation because it says the new life has begun. When you're reborn by the presence and power of Jesus Christ through the Holy Spirit, you are changed into a new person. The new life has begun, but it's a process. And it's not just an event. For some people, it's like a cataclysmic, cathartic event. They hear of Christ once and they're converted. A bit like the thief on the cross on Good Friday. He sees God hanging there and he can't believe that they're killing an innocent man. And the other thief is teasing Jesus and being sarcastic and all that stuff. But this guy says, hey, cut it out. We deserve to die. We're thieves, we're murderers. But this man's done nothing wrong. And so then and there, he just says, Jesus, this is faith. He says, Jesus, remember me when you get to heaven. And Jesus says, son, this day. While Jesus is dying on the cross, he goes, this day you'll be with me in heaven. So there are instantaneous conversions. And there are people in this place that heard the gospel of Jesus once and received him. But for most of us, it's a process. For me, it took nearly 6 months. It was a discovery time. And not everyone has a dramatic conversion experience. Sometimes it's discovery, it's enlightenment, it's understanding, particularly to find reasons for the faith. And one of the things that we do here at the Christian Family Center is we run the Alpha course. And the Alpha is produced by an Anglican church in London, and millions of people across the world have seen it. And we've been doing it as a church family in our small life groups in the first term. And we're running this in May, we're starting it. And if you are on the journey and you're saying, look, I'd like to ask questions, I'd like to understand, because it's a process, I would encourage you to do Alpha, starts May the 8th. It's a wonderful course. About, I think, 8 sessions or so, they're 35, 40 minutes, you can ask questions. And for me, as a 17-year-old who was quite skeptical, I needed to read about, to science and faith mix in. And I ended up doing a sub-major in science and majors in history and politics at university. And I wanted answers to questions. And so if you're on a journey to faith and you're saying, look, I'd like to do something like this, then I would encourage you to let us know on the Connect card that's in on your seat there, and we'll make contact with you. But we'll run these programs every term, but I would encourage you to explore the faith. Maybe for some of you, you're ready to say, you know what, I've heard these young guys and girls. I'm ready this Easter to believe. And I know people in this church who first heard the gospel at Easter, or received Christ in our Easter services, and they've been with us for decades. Maybe you're ready to respond in your heart to say, Jesus, I need you, I want you, I want you to become my Saviour and my Lord. Can I lead you in a prayer? Let's all bow our heads and kids, you join us as well. Let's bow our heads and close our eyes and just reflect for a few moments as we pray. Father, thank you for this service, this special Easter Sunday resurrection celebration. Thank you for these wonderful teenagers and young adults who demonstrated to us their faith by an act of obedience, an act of identification in your death and resurrection. Thank you, Lord, that you are more real to us than life itself. You're the author of life, and you are the one that gives us new life when we place our trust in Jesus. And I pray, Lord, for any here today who are ready to say yes to Jesus Christ, who want to open their hearts and say, 2021, Easter Sunday morning, I open my heart to Jesus Christ. If that's you, in your heart right now, between you and God, just say, Lord, I don't understand it all, but I know I need you in my life. I have many sins that need to be forgiven, and I ask you to forgive me. I need peace in my life. I need purpose. I need meaning. Jesus, I need you, the truth. transformed my heart and life. I receive you now. Amen. Amen. Let's sing this song.
Why don't you stand to your feet?
Nothing comes close to the Lord.
As we prepare to leave this place, there is a meal available in the community hall that my wife and her team have put together. And you're invited to explore the Christian faith on the Alpha course. And if you want to be a part of this, let us know on the Connect card that's also on your seat there. In fact, you may want to just give us your comments about this church. And if you prayed the prayer for Christ to come into your life, let me know, and then we can make contact with you and help you to understand and maybe connect you up also to do the Alpha program. Church family, not our guests, but those of us who are committed to this local church, we're going to take up our offering as we do each week. For those that have cash and checks and that, there are the boxes in the foyer for you. But most of us give online. I think it's 97% of us give online. And I want to say thank you to you for your faithfulness. Last weekend, we took up a very special offering for our church in Alice Springs. From this place here, we have started and have churches now from Darwin, Hobart, Alice Springs, Barossa Valley, Blackwood Hills, Ranella, Lefevre, and also four Indigenous outreach groups in Western Australia, Northern Territory, South Australia that are run by Indigenous pastors and leaders. We're building a facility in Alice Springs, and we collected an offering from all of our churches last week. The good news is that we have raised $151,000 from last week's offering, which is amazing. And that's I think about $120,000 in cash. The others is coming in from this church. You gave at this stage $109,000. So about 2/3 of it came from here and 1/3 from our other churches. If you're part of the Family Center and you're still saying, look, I really want to contribute, I just couldn't do it last week, you can do it today. You can do it online. The details are there. We hope to start putting up the facility probably in May as such. But I just want to say thank you guys for your amazing generosity. And for those of you still contemplating, pray and reflect, and let's make a sizable contribution. I'm trusting we can raise about $200,000 by, say, the next few weeks, ready for us to get the contractors in to put up the basic facility, the stage one. As I mentioned, there is a meal in the community hall. Please stay, or stay for a cup of coffee, share together. Can we stand? In our Greek tradition, we say, and you can say this at the door when you leave, Christos Anesti. And if you say Christos Anesti, it means Christ is risen. But then you've got to say the second part, Alithos Anesti. Indeed, it's true that he is risen. Do you want to say it with me? Christos Alithos Anesti. Every blessing. Have a great day.